Sure, yeah, difficult to put down in a few words, but very disappointed, obviously. Tough to lose the series, and there's obviously still a lot to play for still, but it's never nice to lose a series and almost feel like all hope is gone. But I'm still the kind of guy that will get myself going for that last test match and will get the team going. So still lots to play for, but very disappointed, obviously. I felt we were in the game lots of times throughout the test match and just didn't grab those opportunities. Now, that's some of the best bowling I've faced from the whole unit. Look, obviously the conditions suited them really well, and they made full use of that, but they asked a lot of questions right throughout our innings. They didn't ask as many questions in the first innings, and I thought that's where we missed a trick. But this time around, they were spot on, a little bit fuller in their lengths, and they asked questions all the time, and the ball was moving around a lot. But they showed some good skill, and you've got to give credit to them for that, especially Brody, obviously, getting the results. But I thought as a unit, they bowled pretty well. I think they'll learn a lot. Not long ago, I was that youngster in the team, going through ups and downs at test level, personally and as a team, a while back. And you learn a lot from that. It's important just to survive at the moment and for a youngster to get through this and not to give up. But definitely gaining a lot of experience. And if guys like Kagiso and others and a few others get through this patch, they'll become much better cricketers moving forward. We're not the same side anymore. Lots of different players, but I don't know. It's a difficult question to answer. We're still up there in the rankings and all of that, but that means absolutely nothing. I believe our form of late has been pretty poor, and it'll take something special to turn it around. It's important for us to keep fighting and to keep trying to find that that mould of cricket we're looking to play. But we're a little bit offbeat at the moment, that's for sure. Yeah, look, Dales, without even playing, still the number one test bowler in the world. He's been for a long time. So, yes, obviously we miss him, but there's no excuse in that. We miss Averne as well. I can name you quite a few guys. We miss Gallis as well. So, but this is the team we have, and this is the team I believe in. And it's up to the 11 here, and the 11 that will get picked to play at Supersport Park to turn things around and to find something special. That's the way those past players did it, like a Callis and a Smith, and a Dale not playing at the moment. Hopefully he will come back still, but that's the way they did it. They had some tough times, and they found a way to get back and to get to the top of the leaderboard and of the rankings. And we've got to find a way now with what we have to become the best. I was never thinking of leaving Test cricket at all. I was just trying to find a way to rest a little bit throughout the year. So lots of thoughts have been crossing my mind, but this has got absolutely no influence in that whatsoever. I also mentioned in some of the interviews I've had that playing on the cricket pitch has never been an issue for me. I've always loved it, and I always will love it. It's just a matter of really keeping myself fresh and keeping myself motivated. It's really tough to stay on top of your game if you play 11 to, I don't know, sometimes even 12 months a year. And so just got to try and find a bit of a balance with my cricket to keep that fight going and keep that skill level up.